Just from my experience, I do not think there's a better lure to catch a giant fish than with a jig. And it's just like, it's magic. For me, especially when I'm flipping, it's strictly a vertical presentation. You know, that's not to say a football jig or a finesse jig dragged around won't get you a lot of bites, but I find I catch more big fish with strictly a vertical presentation. So I wanna make a lot of drops. You know, I'll let the jig, like I'll pitch right next to that dock pole and I'll let it, what I call skin in the pole. So actually, if there's moss or something growing on that pole, I want that jig to create a disturbance. I want it to take that moss off going down the pole. And one of the keys to doing that is with your rod position. Let that bait fall vertically, follow that bait down. I call it a controlled slack line. I want to be in touch with my lure, but I don't want to hinder the fall of the lure. And if you achieve that perfect controlled slack line, you will be in that perfect hook set position when you get a bite. So I like my perfect hook set position for me is somewhere between 9 and 10 o'clock. So about right here is where I want to be to drive that hook home. I don't want to be up here and I don't want to be tight line like this. When I'm in this position, it allows me to let that fish run a little bit, let that fish move, let him make sure he has that bait. When I'm sure he's got it in his mouth, let him have it. When you think that bait has hit the bottom, sometimes it hadn't hit the bottom. Sometimes it's in a fish's mouth. So I like to just ease up on the rod until I feel the weight of that jig. And if you feel something funny, set the hook. I mean, hook sets are free. I can't tell you how many times I don't feel a bite with a jig, but something, there's just a pressure there. Something doesn't feel right. And a lot of times that'll be your biggest bite of the day. I like a light reel, but you know what? I don't like a super, super fast reel. I mean, we got reels now that are, you know, I mean, they're just so many inches per reel handle. And then there's super slow reels, which is what I like when I deep crank. So you have to have that right balance. For me, this is a 7.2:1. It's I would consider it in the middle of the range. It's not slow, it's not fast. And why I like this reel is it's still fast enough so I don't waste a lot of time and effort getting that bait back in, but it's slow enough when I hook a fish back in that grass, I feel like it's got more power to winch him out. So it's definitely a balancing act with the speed of your reel, and that's why I like that reel that falls somewhere in the middle of that speed range. Okay, this is a perfect example of what I'm talking about with rod position. So I'm coming down this bank, I'm watching my depth finder. I'm right here on the end of this dock and there's a drop. It's actually 14 feet right under my trolling motor right here. So you can have a good idea that right on the end of that dock, right in the shade where I just landed that jig, you're probably looking in that 13, 14 foot range. So what you saw there is kind of an exaggerated version of how I let that jig fall vertically on a 14 foot dock. Jig entered the water, following it down. Jig just hit the bottom. See where my rod is? Perfect hook set position. So if you'll follow those tips, think about that rod position based on the depth that you're flipping and pitching, and you will definitely catch not only more fish, but a lot bigger fish.